Hey, welcome back. So, we're still in the Wine Wars. If you watched the last video, you saw when we went and took care of the problems on the Vermentino vineyard. What you did not see is, we had some, let's call them technical difficulties. Totally unavoidable, of course. And we went and took care of the problems on the Coronada vineyard as well. It was mostly the same stuff, a bunch of archospores, those big gross spitty plants. And let me see, there was one issue with bandits, and there was a bridge that had a couple rock trolls as well, but they didn't say anything, so that was boring. We fought those and found a note which indicated which seemed to indicate
A third party's guilt.
basically accusing Miss Vermentino here of sabotaging his farm. But we had found exactly the same note suggesting that he had sabotaged hers. So we went and looked. Geralt decided it was obviously a third party messing with them both. We went and looked and found a small warehouse which had evidence that a count had in fact been behind the entire thing. I forget his name off the top of my head, but he was one of the victims of the beast that brought us here. And now we are going to
They're about to go
The
over
beast.
that and explain it in a little more detail right now.
The beast that brought us to this country, rather, the main quest. So we are gonna go tell them that all their problems are solved. And since we already saw this cutscene, we know we're gonna also go check out the third vineyard, which they're squabbling over. Let's go.
Master Witcher, have you any news?
One and the same man caused Coronado's and Vermentino's problems. Got proof. A certain Count Crespi. He's at the root of it all.
What, Crespi? Belgard's erstwhile owner? Why, that's impossible.
Got it all here, in writing.
He did indeed have motive. He knew well his own vineyard could not survive if Vermentino and Coronado were to join forces.
Probably why he incited the feud. Pulled it off, too, mostly. Just failed to bring his plan to completion when the beast got him.
Incredible. You mean to say it wasn't Liam?
And I was certain my troubles were Matilda's doing. In light
Those
of
two are
new
such
evidence,
suckers.
The most
Oh, yeah.
just resolution would be for both injured parties to share oversight of Belgard.
Wait just a minute. Do you mean to suggest we're to cooperate?
It's the optimal solution, yes. In terms of the health of the enterprise as well?
I can't believe I'm saying this, but I do believe he's right. Perhaps it is time to bury the hatchet.
I still
Three
think they should
vineyards
kiss.
are more than one. There's
Yeah.
much to be gained. So be it.
That's not all. The troubles at your vineyards? Solved them. You can go back to operating normally now.
Splendid news. I'm
He's so
relieved to
smug
see you
about
hired
that.
a professional, especially one whose aid might still prove invaluable. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. Follow me. It's high time you saw Belgard.
Witcher, come with us, please. Something tells me we'll have tasks for you yet.
All right, let's go.
My desire for Belgard to pass into capable hands was no idle whim. For the vineyard's fallen upon hard times since its previous owner's demise. I've been told of workers dying on their rounds, monsters prowling about. Before anyone can call this home, they will have to deal with these inconveniences. That is the minister's wish.
More work for me, I guess.
If you're willing, we'll gladly accept your help.
Yeah, sure. Let's talk
I can help, sure, but I won't work for free.
I just agreed to do it last time. This seems.
Did
this
we agree
seem.
To do it
I
this
think we
time?
can push this a little bit. Just a little bit. 1200 might be a bit much. Let's try 1150.
Too much. Definitely too much.
Alright, fucking deal with your weed problem on your own.
Oh, she's got a weed problem, alright. She got Kristen Stewart face, man.
A bit less? Is that out of the question? A bit less? Is that out of the question?
Holy crap, you're stingy for someone who owns a vineyard and a half.
Yeah, maybe that's how she came to own it, by being super stingy. I've never seen what happens when that little bar maxes out.
Fine, we have a deal.
And I guess we're not going to find out now.
More or less already agreed, I guess.
Oh, that's a weight off my chest, I must say. Your reward shall be fair, I promise.
I'll get to
you
work.
You just watched us haggle.
Yeah, I know, right? Alright, so are we going to have set of tangleweeds here or no?
Alright, well, we got 5 more problems. So, was this? No, this wasn't where we were before. We traveled somewhere.
Yeah, we fast traveled to the new vineyard. This is new to us.
Alright, let's see where we're at and how far away the problems are.
Dang. That is some distance covered.
Where's the fifth one? There it is. Okay.
Oh, that would do it.
2, 3, 4, and 5. All right. Well, at least one of them's close.
That's true. May as well start with the closest in this case.
Hell, we can walk there. Let's walk there.
Yeah, no need for Roach yet. That was my favorite season of Tenchi Muyo.
Roach can just, find new walls to get stuck in on his own.
I'm going to say, what does Roach do for relaxation? Then I realized I might not want to know.
Alright. Well, it's not, not plants.
Hey, that's something. I'll take it.
So, I mentioned this in, let's call it the Lost episode. These guys are one of the more obvious benefits for knowing what their weakness is, because any blast of air is gonna knock them on their ass totally. So this, and also like wraiths and noon wraiths and whatnot, which you have to put a little trap field down, and then they'll materialize once they cross it.
I think they've vaguely also mentioned that where I'm at.
Yeah, there's also there's also spider enemies that they introduced in Hearts of Stone, which it's weird. It feels like it's not supposed to happen, but if you drop an Irden trap, they like start getting electrified and can't move. It's weird.
Yeah, it sounds
good. Let's find out what Terry Pyers had to say. This job sucks. This job sucks.
Huh. Oh my god.
Giant centipede? Would you call that a centipede?
I don't know if that's what we just saw was a centipede.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, no, I would definitely not call those that. So maybe it's talking about something else.
Either way, right,
Roach,
need a horse.
Where are you? What?
Thank you.
Sure.
Yeah.
No problem. I think that happened last time as well.
To be fair, that's happening on all these places. We show up, cut down a few monsters, and then some dude who did not notice us goes, thanks!
Yeah, sometimes there's a lengthy cutscene where you meditate until, like, a day has passed to totally screw with your beard level if you haven't fixed that.
Just saying, man, that new agey music.
Where
time.
The hell am I going? Okay, there's a path.
Yay.
I'm not really... I didn't see what attacked me. That's okay.
Giddy up.
Alright. What now? More Andrigas, you think? Oh, nope. That's something different.
Yeah.
Maybe this is the centipedes.
Let's foe.
Yep. Okay. Oh, shit. Those were in the first game, too.
Well, I guess they're reusing.
They sucked there, and they seem to suck here, too. Alright, I think some mind control is exactly what these guys need to calm the hell down. Nope, not, I did it and he just dove directly underground. Yeah, that doesn't work at all. Oh, great.
Well, shit.
Nope. Oh yeah, so off screen I went through various stats. I'll show it off in a minute if these guys will ever die. Yeah, what do I need to do? But I seriously upped the damage I seriously upped the stats for the fire spell.
Makes sense.
Because that was doing piddly damage, but it seemed to like actually work to stun the enemies. Though, right now alright, I'm gonna try a crossbow. Nope. These guys are really annoying.
Yeah, they seem like pretty cool, man. Just the one.
There. Jeez.
Oh. Yeah, I looked miserable.
That was kind of crappy. Alright. So there should be something here in these most of these legs. Gross.
Well, at least there's a couple of nice items.
Yeah, geological survey, just like the other one said.
Ha! Ha! Oh, wow. The Count is a dick.
There are no centipedes here, promise.
The dead Count was clearly the mayor from Jaws. Holy shit.
I'm gonna go ahead and go over here. Oh yeah, so what I did, first I went into the character screen and I got the Igni intensity, as many ranks of that as I could get, which I guess I just leveled up so I can get another one.
Nice. Yeah, I've
and
got that one.
I did that and I replaced the alternate Quen. Where is that? The alternate Quen, which was the active shield that I showed off and have never obviously never used since. So screw that. And I do kind of want to get the alternate Irden up, but there's nothing else here that I really want to get rid of. I got the 20 minutes food. That's not going away ever. Fire intensity. Using delusion in dialogue. There's no way that I'm getting rid of that one.
Yeah, that's intended.
Just, and also all of the general damage ones. Strong attack, weak attack, or quick attack, and then critical hits for both the fleet-footed, which I mentioned before, which is dodging and completely nullifies damage as long as you actually do the timing correctly, and this counterattack, which, if I can do it right, does an ass load of damage.
Seems good to me.
I also went in and remembered to put runes onto my armor. So I got two each for Igni, Ard, and Irden for 10% boost, which it's a little weird how it does that. Basically, what it says I did for fire damage, it went up by about 25%, so we'll see. And I've also got some extra attack power and some other random stuff here. And
I think that'll cover us for a bit.
Actually, before we go on, let's put some dye onto this shirt and see what happens.
Do we have anything other than brown and pink?
Nope.
Okay.
So I'm going to do brown or pink? Which one? I'm thinking pink.
Pink's probably going to stand out more.
Yeah.
Let's see how visible
and
these
are. And I can get rid of it.
Oh, nice. It gives a little preview, too.
Yeah.
That's actually
kind of like that.
Yeah, that's a really nice.
That's a much duller shade of pink than I expected. Ew. That's a much poopier shade of brown than I expected.
Yeah, the pink is more of a rose color on the gear. Okay, there we go.
What? I know this.
Look, man, something patched, so now you have to know it again.
Alright. You know what? I'm keeping it.
I dig that. Yeah, it's not jarring or anything.
Alright. We can check out other dyes if we see them.
I think there's some way to craft them based on what I thought I saw in the note.
You can craft most anything. Alright.
That's okay. True, but I also know...
Anybody? I wonder if there's anybody home. That cat really just... That was a hell of a hiss.
Is it true peasants gotta carve his cows himself nowadays?
What? I'm just gonna assume he was not talking about fucking cows and...
Carve.
Oh. He said cow with an L.
Oh. I thought he said carve his own cows.
No.
That might take on a slightly weirder tone.
Yeah, maybe just, like, helping them give birth, probably.
Oh yeah, that would work
but
too.
It still seems like a weird way to say that.
Look, man, it's France. It's witch France.
I'm not sure who else was supposed to calve the cows.
Midway?
Oh shit.
Huh.
I'm gonna avoid that skull bear.
Skull bear is pretty good. Dude, this guy has a whole palace on his friggin' vineyard.
I mean, there's ruins kind of everywhere.
Whoa, what the hell?
That's weird. I'm going to say...
Oh, okay,
I don't think we can do anything yet. Alright. We'll be back.
You know, maybe the glowing eldritch hell portal has something to do with the problems around here.
Yeah, most of the time, if you see something like that and you can't do anything about it, it'll be in the main quest somewhere.
Alright.
Alright, we're about 50 steps away from the next wine problem, which is quite a ways away from the other wine problems. So I don't know if it's a top priority.
Oh,
it was probably... It was this far away because they were stealing someone. Alright.
Well, that makes sense.
How long are you gonna make me wait?
Oh, well, that's a... interesting way to look at that.
Oops, shit.
Save me!
Yeah, I'm working on it. Yeah, I have noticed that the bandits and stuff seem to be reacting to the fire much more than they were before.
Oh, yeah.
Hey guys, wait a second, it's gonna be cool. Yeah. Isn't this cool?
Hey, it's handy. You know, this last guy probably could have just grabbed the hostage and would have been smarter for him.
Hey, didn't program that in.
Yeah.
All right, what do you got for sale?
Yeah, clearly.
I thank you, sir. Were it not for you, well, those bandits were not pulling pranks. I could pound some new steel for you in gratitude, but I must first return to my workshop in Belgard.
Yeah, let's go. It's probably going to be a lot closer.
Let's go.
That
time to leave.
Accent was insane.
Yeah, the accents are definitely not as consistent as they were in the main game.
I thank you again for your aid. Care to glance at my wares?
Maybe some other time.
What were you doing in the Caraberta Woods? And how'd you wind up a prisoner of those bandits?
Ever since the Count died, I've not had the resources to buy raw materials. Meaning no new barrel hoops, new
tools. It kind of reminds me in, did you play Bioshock Infinite?
No, I did not.
Okay, so there's one area, I don't think this guy's going to say anything interesting, but, there's a sequence that takes place on a beach, and there's a bunch of, sort of beach-like area, and there's a bunch of people sitting around in swimsuits, this one guy is sitting right next to it.
That we ran into.
Hang on, this guy's actually talking about
more luck than sense because you came along to save me.
Oh no, he's just.
Thank
you. Anyway, there's this guy sitting in front of like a caravan or something, just a cart. What do you call it? Like a covered wagon.
Mm-hmm.
And he's like, "Hey, you look real strong. You got real good muscles. I think one of these tank suits would look real good on you. You should come on back and take a look at that." And he just basically just hits on you like 12 different ways.
Huh.
Show me what you have.
I've never seen anybody actually mention that like anywhere talking about the game, which I always thought was interesting. Solution for mixing dyes. What the hell? Why not? It was just it was just like one of those. Oh, hey, they do remember there were gay people in the 20s.
Yeah. Hey, that's a plus. I'll take it.
Yeah, it doesn't seem to be much of anything there. I wonder if I need. Oh, I can probably find a specific person who will. Craft the dyes.
Yeah.
See ya.
It looks it's a little weird with the pants. The pants are still not quite.
They
right.
stand
Maybe.
Out.
But I'm just gonna see. I don't think this is gonna be better. No, that's not better at all.
Nah, although it kind of works on the gloves.
Yeah. It's kind of too yellow.
Gotcha. I have a pair that looks like that, so that's why I think it's nice.
Well, how dare you?
Hey, work gloves is work gloves, man.
Alright, are you the only person here?
Well, maybe at this hour.
Yeah. Also, they did go into a lot of detail about how all the workers are, like, dying and stuff.
That's also true. But hey, we're going to fix that, and then this place is going to be right as rain.
Yep.
Clearly, well, these other two things are going to involve us meditating and, like, summoning people.
It'll be right as acid rain, maybe.
Yeah, that's true.
Ain't gonna kill you. Maybe not the best for you.
Wouldn't drink it.
It's kind of unfortunate that this quest is just kind of the same thing three times. Because the whole thing with the two people fighting over land, that seemed really interesting.
Yeah, I expected there to be a little more nuance to the ending than just, yep, the third guy did it. I mean, investigating who it actually was would have been more interesting while we clean this place up.
Yeah. Or if it had actually been one of the two and there was like a bunch of evidence pointing different directions.
Yeah, that would also be interesting.
All right, I got a slizzard there. I'm going to assume that's, I believe I've got wyvern oil. Something like that. Hybrid oil? I think that might be it.
Let's find out.
Well, if it doesn't work, it won't make it any worse.
Doesn't seem to be hurting.
This thing doesn't have any eyes, I think.
I think you're right. It looks like it has a sandworm head.
Oops, nope, not close enough.
Yeah, its hitbox is weird.
Yeah, all the hitboxes on the flying things are kind of weird, and also the hit reactions. Like, I'm definitely hitting it, it's just sometimes not making any noise.
It's not registering, I'm not seeing a Geralt hit for X.
To shove my sword in its face a few times.
Oh, hey,
and
yeah,
now
we
wait.
Really are going to.
Let's watch the sunrise.
Yep. And our Estus flask refills. Did I do that right? I'm not very good at those games.
What? I just saved your asses. Shut up. Go get some pants on.
Look, man, that's how they work in France. Pantsless. Work, yet they had to drink themselves sick. A job is like
a lady. You can always get a new one. There are a lot of people just without pants in Witcher 2. Not as many here.
Thank goodness. I don't want to see old men without pants.
I'm not going to pretend it horrifies me.
I'm not going to pretend it horrifies me, but it doesn't mean I want to see it.
Wait, there's a body cart here. There was something on a different one of these.
Hey, there we go.
Dearest cousin, you're right. This place sucks.
Holy crap.
Okay. Well, we got one more wine problem, and then maybe this will come to an end, and we can go ahead and move on to something else.
Why would you fire all the guards? That just seems like an incredibly stupid idea.
You don't need guards in the Witcher world. Come on.
I mean, I guess. I suppose when people are leaving eyeless wyverns on your friggin' property, the guards won't do much.
Of course, it's also not ice and fire where you hire a guard and, like, 80% chance they're just going to stab you in the back.
Yeah, that's true. That place definitely sucks more than Witcherland.
I think the place sucks less. The people suck way more.
The place kind of sucks more, dude. There's an apocalyptic death ball.
I mean, okay, just because there's some ancient zombie curse about to come wipe everyone out, which they still haven't actually gotten to at any point in the book. Books? I don't know about the show.
Yeah, they went there this year, so be careful. These dudes seem 100% worse than the freaking plants.
I wish I could find something that will actually stop them. Like, maybe one of my bombs, but I don't really want to go scrolling through 8 different bombs and trying them.
We should probably check after we finish these guys off in the bestiary.
Yeah, see if they showed up in the...
Yeah.
Hold on, I'm gonna fix my sword. Ordinarily, I would not do it in battle, but I just want to get this over with as quickly as possible.
No, I understand. I'm just gonna throw something out there. These bad hitboxes might be making this worse.
Well, they're armored in the back. Is part of what's making this such a pain.
Yeah, but I mean the fact that they pop out within any distance of you and you fly backwards doesn't help.
Yeah.
Because that pop out is bullshit.
There. Jeez.
Should destroy it.
Yes, I should.
Yep. Eat shit.
Alright, I solved some more wine problems. What was I gonna do? Bestiary. It should be under insectoids.
I figured it had to be Irritant.
I thought I tried that.
I don't recall seeing it, but it's possible I missed it because signs are sort of hard to notice in the process.
They are very fast, so I guess that would make sense.
Well,
all right. Well, I'm an idiot, probably. Anyway, let's go turn this in, and then
maybe finally go look at that body that's been sitting in a thing for a week.
Yeah.
Cellar.
Or we could go check out those cows.
Yeah, we may as well just round this out with cows.
Yeah, we're still at about 30 minutes on the video, so. And I suspect that one won't take that long, but I guess we'll find out.
It's either not going to take long, or it's going to be its own Wine Wars-esque quest.
Yeah. Or. Or it might be out of my level range. I don't actually know. I will find out.
I think it's in your range.
I will find out in just a minute.
Yeah.
The actual paths around this place are really windy.
Yeah.
Like, I think way, way more so than the main game.
Well, to be fair, part of that is probably that these are friggin' vineyards and you don't want a direct route going through the plants.
Not so fast, Rose.
Yeah. Can just hang out down there, Roach.
That's okay. He'll find some way to tunnel into this wall.
Roach will always find a way to get to you. whether it follows the laws of time and space or not.
Look, man, the centipedes made a lot of tunnels, and Roach can crawl into those.
Hey, you guys are having a little party, huh? Really? Cool. Can I join your party, or am I too covered in giant centipede blood?
Tended to
oh, see, I thought you were
going to
try and flip the table.
Should be in as good a shape as ever.
Okay.
Splendid. And thus, officially, by the power vested in me, I grant you title to the Belgard Vineyard, and trust that you shall make good use of its grounds and resources.
Later.
Peace.
Excellent. Ah, I can already smell the grapes ripening into sun.
We shan't forget what you did for us. Here, your pay.
But that's not all. You must come back and see us shortly. We've a surprise in store for you.
I'll do that. Farewell.
Was your armor wineberry colored when you came here?
Nah, it's fine.
What are you doing, Geralt? What?
Oh, wait. This might be better.
Oh, man.
There we go. That's comfortable.
Yeah.
Alright.
I did a lot of that in the Witcher training ground, so I understand.
Alright, let's see. I believe that should be under Witcher contracts. Yeah, 38.
Alright.
Want to do it?
Let's do it.
Alright. Cows falling from the sky. This ought to be a nice refresher. Let's see. It's quite far away. Is there a quick travel point that I can go to?
Not one that we've just...
Flovive.
Yeah.
Flovive, right here. All right. Flovive. Flovive. Whatever.
I'm not trying to make these make sense with normal human language.
Actually, where is the local one?
We didn't find it. There's got to be one somewhere around where you are.
We'll see. This place is a little too big to not have one.
Yeah. I figure you just circle around the outside of this villa.
Yeah.
Good horse.
Horsehair!
I've lots to do before it gets
dark. All right. Designers.
Sometimes they're at like crossroads just down.
That's
why
I was thinking, yeah.
That's not it.
Okay.
Hmm.
Well, hell.
Slow now. Whoa.
Ah. Whoa, what the hell is this?
Alright, I'll go on foot. You have fun there.
Place is a friggin' mess.
If it's not out here, I don't know where it would be.
Yeah. Well, this sucks.
Here, I think this is where I started.
Yeah. Shit, cock.
Maybe I'll find a merchant that'll, sell me some maps.
That would be nice.
Oh, fucking.
Take it easy.
Damn this place to hell.
Well, Roach knew. I was trying to go the other direction.
Eh, at least somebody's got their head on straight, even if it's incredibly long. Wow, Skellige sounds like a real crazy town.
Skellige is not the nicest place in the world. No.
Well, I just got to see something about a boat made from the fingernails of the dead, so yeah. Seems like a real charming place.
They got some legends. Alright, where... Nope. Sometimes when I press, like, left, or if I... Just now it happened. I pressed right on the control stick and Roach just turned left.
Look, man, horse is gonna horse.
Something here.
Go, go.
But it seems to be underground, so I will just leave it.
Take it easy.
Come on, Rich. You can do it. seems less inclined to stay on the roads than he was anywhere else in the game.
I was going to ask if you were using the sprint button or whatever it is that keeps him on the auto path. Yeah.
When I'm trying, sometimes it doesn't seem to work and I can't tell if it's my fault or the game's fault.
You know, I'm not sure, because I've seen it go both ways.
Yeah. Ooh. Really? Nope, don't you dare.
Huh. Well, cows falling from the sky, a giant
seems
quarry.
Like, hey, this seems like a good place to drop a cow, honestly.
Yeah. I was going to say this is the plot of a lost Doctor Who serial, but that works too. That's a hand.
This is a hand.
Okay, forget Doctor Who. This is becoming Monty Python very quickly.
I don't know. Unearthing some giant mystical statue sounds pretty Doctor Who to me. They dug, and then they found aliens.
Oof. Hey. I like how both of us are avoiding the elephant in the room here on that one.
What the golly blasting devils are you doing, men? What plague? An unfortunate turn of events, that's all.
They have some get fun cursing in this place.
If we don't deliver that hat on time, the infestor will twist my plums off.
Is that what you'll tell Emil's widow? That a cow crushed him and it was an accident? This, sir, is a grave matter. It requires a specialist, some mage or warlock.
What happened here?
Major Warlock here.
Look, it's that witcher who's come to town. Maybe he can do something. An exorcism or the like. We should ask how much coin he'll want.
Saw your notice. Got a problem with a cow. Fear a plague, is that it?
Yes, indeed. And a horrid one at that. We've irked the gods something true we have. In Zeracania, they've sent a plague of locusts, then of frogs, with us.
I don't remember that part of the Bible.
Right to raining cows down on us.
I do, but only because of Sunday school dropouts.
Enough! No need to so panic. Come, Master Witcher, I shall divulge to you the matter at hand. Yes, an unfortunate matter indeed, to be crushed by a cow. A true shame, Emil.
No kidding.
He was a good worker. I told them at once there had to be a simple explanation. But that lot, no. Right away, they started in screaming, plague! Demanding higher wages for hardship. Poor working conditions, you see? They'll ruin me, the blotters.
My job is to figure out why a cow fell from the sky. That it?
That too. The thing is, since none bothered to clear the cow corpse, some filths overrun the other pit. We fear to venture.
There we go.
Yeah.
Some rock fiends over there.
Cow, where'd it come from? What kind was it?
Why, the ordinary spotted kind. Nothing unusual. Its corpse rots in the other pit, sends out its stench, and Emil lies right beneath it. Will you tend to the matter and take on the contract?
What exactly is going on here?
Construction of a statue of the Prophet Lepiota. We're carving it.
Oh, this is probably tied into that other one.
Piece by piece, a pious infestus revived the project after years of neglect. He's engaged all nearby quarries in its completion.
And we would be on schedule were it not for the finding pieces of it all over the place. All right.
That makes sense. Look into it.
They definitely seem to be tying the side quests and stuff together better.
I'm down with this.
I need to know more about this accident. Anyone actually see what happened?
No, but sounds there were. Osterv had just gone to see how Emil was getting along when suddenly we heard an ear-botching boom. Moments later, something smashed into one of the cranes.
Doubt it was the cow that hit the crane.
Probably true. At any rate, come morn, we ventured out to sea, but the vermin drove us off. With that, all work came to a halt. Has remained so since. Master, tarry no longer, please. Will you take on the matter?
I won't haggle.
Fine, I'll look into it. Might be a botched portal, but I doubt it.
La Piota rewards you with progeny aplenty. I should keep an
nice.
Eye out for your return.
This is a guy who doesn't know how witchers work.
Fill your life with babies. Hi, dog.
Yo.
Hey. Bye, dog.
You just held out a cupcake. Would have done the same damn thing.
I don't have a cupcake. I do have magic.
Fair enough.
Alright, where am I going? Up.
We need to go to the other pit.
Well, at least it's easier to get out than there was some... Remember a couple other games with pits like this that were a bit maze-like.
You know, oh, I like, don't know what you could be talking about, Shin Megami Tensei.
I was thinking World of Warcraft, actually.
Oh, I have no experience also, with that.
Also, there was one, at least one in one of the Fallout games, one of the 3D ones.
Oof. Yeah, I think that's 4 you're talking about.
Alright, let's go fight some monsters.
Yeah.
Looks like ghouls. That should be easy enough.
That makes some sense.
Oh, that's right. The crane fell, so that's why there's wreckage all over the place. That makes sense.
What? Huh?
Okay.
That dude rules.
You guys just hang out there. I'll do everything. Don't worry.
Well, that makes sense.
So, owl ghouls need to do an axie when they put out their spikes, because otherwise you can't actually hit them.
Oh, okay. Well, that went quick.
Yep. Alright, what do we got? Cow and a body.
Yep.
No real good place to drop a cow from.
Something hit the crane.
Must be Emil. Workers mentioned him. Poor guy. Unlucky as all hell. Right. Now where do I start?
Can I say I really love these scenes?
Crushed by something heavy.
I like them. Just cracked. Sitting there talking fresh to himself about marks, the disgusting things that he sees.
They got to him after his death. Won't learn anything else from the body.
Don't wink at the camera,
issues
asshole.
Crushed in places. Must have fallen from quite a height.
Bite
wounds. Got sliced open. Not much blood, so it happened after death. Or it had already stopped pumping. Deep marks. Small ones, though. So necrophages left them clearly. Sure sniffed out their feast fast.
Looks like this cow fell.
Deep claw wounds. Spread between talons indicates a draconid. A wyvern probably. But these wounds weren't the cause of death. Got it. All clear now. Cow died when it fell from a great height. Draconid must have dropped it. A youngster probably.
The blood spawning in is making this really funny.
Emil's bad luck to be standing right underneath. And then there's the crane.
Alright, let's go investigate the crane. Let's find the way up and then investigate the crane. Let's check out this poster and then find the way up. Okay.
Are we going to hit the notice board down here while we're here?
Sure.
Up to you. I just figured since we're next to it.
I totally was not paying attention.
That's okay.
What do we got? Attention cripples.
Oh, man.
Well, it's a living.
Yeah.
Sure. Probably nothing.
Oh.
We buy unusual looking stones. Sure.
Oh man.
There weren't actually any quests on there.
Yeah.
Just some question marks on the map.
Yeah, I was gonna say. I gotta admit, I have to give this game props for using the term hydrophobia. Let me tell you about the time I read way too much about rabies and its cultural history.
We have to do this further up, or maybe I have to be down at the bottom. Oh god. There we go.
Yeah, I'm thinking on the top.
Blood. Draconid must have hit it pretty hard. Dropped the cow, then probably tried to steady its flight.
Alright, let's follow some bloodstains.
Good.
Yep.
Should be simple to track down. Traces of draconid blood, barely perceptible. I'm on the right track.
Following's bloodstains in The Witcher 3.
That is kind of how a lot of these quests end.
Yeah, unfortunately, the contracts get a little repetitive if you do too many of them right in a row.
Well, there's a reason I break them up.
Yeah. We're only doing the one.
Started That's bleeding true. Heavily. Wound was more serious than I thought, looks like.
Are we just going to end up finding a dead dragon?
Yeah, probably, and or like killed by some other bigger monster.
Also possible.
That's what we'd have to fight.
Smells ha! Like sour mash. Dragon must have attacked the steel. Bastard.
I love that that's what makes Geralt get angry about this.
He has very few pleasures, and one of them is drink. Another one is sex with ladies.
That's true. I do love that their damage will hurt their friends.
Nope.
Right next to the big cliff.
On the roof of the distillery, raised a ruckus, made a mess, then moved on. Paw prints. Crawled through here. Clearly too tired to fly.
Hmm.
Well,
was in a bad
I wonder
way.
If we are going to have to find anything crawling. At the end of this.
I think this is just going to be a corpse.
Second draconid landed here. A larger one. Waited for the smaller one to heal. Then they flew off together. Should be easy to track. Smaller one was still bleeding, luckily.
Never mind.
Alright, let's keep going.
Flew off together. Probably bound for their nest.
Where are we?
Oh, well.
Okay. I'm guessing we're going there.
That's my guess. Maybe it's that missing sun.
Maybe.
Trail ends here. Nest's up there. I bet the farm on it.
Well, I mean, that's kind of an obvious clue.
Yeah. Alright, I'm gonna double check. I believe it. They are hybrids.
No.
Griffins, Aranias. No. Maybe not. They might be, Draconids, of course.
That makes sense.
Alright, so that oil that I put on earlier did absolutely nothing.
Ardquin and Draconid oil. Well, that's not bad.
There it is. Alright, let's kill us some some slizzards.
Yep, they have the irritating hitboxes. Oh man, platforming.
Yep.
You know what's a genre that I really hate is making a comeback? The 3D platformer.
I fucking love it. I'm ready.
I wish you luck. Oh, well.
Okay, so. Start by attacking you, and switching over to the one to the air blast, so I can actually do stuff to you. Oh, jeez. Okay.
It's not the worst. Oh, that's pretty good.
The problem is stuff like burning. When you're caught by it, you cannot heal at all, and
yeah, I see that.
And the effect kind of lasts a little bit after it stops draining your health, but not like in any consistent way. So, there we go. I'm gonna...
So it's a slizzard.
I cannot do what I was going to do. Okay.
Okay.
Maybe it's just the one until you kill it. Then the other.
Halfway in, he went, oh, the sun is joining the fray.
Okay. Come on.
These hitboxes are atrocious.
There we go.
Yeah.
Okay. I was too busy trying not to get burned.
Yeah, now it seems to be bringing out the guns. Oh, good.
Fortunately, also the lock-on for the bosses is a little weird.
Flying anything is a weird lock-on.
Okay, I think I got this.
I'm not gonna say anything, I don't wanna jinx it.
I've got this, assuming I can actually hit it.
Yeah, that seems to be the problem here.
There we go. Alright.
Right. High time I collected a trophy.
I like how he doesn't use a good knife for this.
Would you?
No, I suppose not.
Alright, so we got a trophy. It usually auto-attaches to the horse. Yeah, there's a... Ugh.
Dang.
That's gross. What does it do? 10% chance to dismember? I will go ahead and keep that on, I suppose.
That seems fair to me.
None of the trophies actually do much great much that's great, like 5% gold, sometimes it's experience, stuff like that. How do I get down from here? What?
Ooh. Yeah, that seems reasonable.
Come on.
I think it's on.
There is a...
Giddy up.
Let's go with that.
There is a place of power nearby.
Let's go find that.
Slow now. Whoa.
I'm just going on foot. Okay.
I'm just going to go on foot. Hops off the side of a mountain.
That's fine.
This ain't Saints Row, man.
Alright, I seem to have totally missed it, but that's fine. I'll come back.
I'm sure.
Right, we'll now, be. We should turn this in and.
Call this video? Yeah.
Yeah, call it a video. Assuming I can find where my fucking horse just spawned.
Bookman, Roach does what Roach does.
I. Well aware.
Whoa.
Told you. Told you he goes vertical.
This is where we splice in the sitcom laughter.
So yeah, you have to do it after he lets out a neigh.
That's true.
What if Roach really is the Fonzie of this game?
You realize I just imagined a horse smacking a jukebox, and that's hilarious, right?
Nothing wrong with that.
So would that make what he's wearing now a denim saddlebag?
Sure. Sure, that can be jeans. Why not?
Yeah. Well, you know what his catchphrase has to be, right?
Nope.
Nay! No apologies.
Well, have you learned how that cow came to fly?
Yeah, you can get back to work. And it wasn't a plague of falling cows.
Did I not say so from the start? A weight off my chest. So what
I hope
was
I can lie to him.
Behind the animal's plummet?
I know, right?
Young slizzard flying over the quarry
nope.
Dropped it.
Damn.
Was trying to get it back to its nest, food for its mother and siblings. Probably heard the last of the beasts. Burned the nest, eggs, everything.
A praiseworthy precaution, but as I said, I can only pay you what we agreed. I simply haven't any more.
Here, take this. And I thank you, Master.
You know how I can tell this isn't a BioWare game? Because we didn't just have the option to tell him, no, give it to the workers.
All cleared up now, right? No gods,
yeah,
no
fuck
play,
that.
Just the dragon, but it's gone too. We're to pay
they didn't
the
kill
the
dragon.
Yeah.
And that will be that. So, why do you still stand there and wait, man? Back to work, chop chop.
And I've a notion suspicious workings are still afoot. What became of the builders who were to put the statue together? They were due 3 days back, yet there's still no sign of them at our daystone.
They were crushed too, I'm certain of it. Or eaten, or locusts got them, like in Zerikania.
What's this rubbish you spout now? The architect wrote they would arrive a week late with a large shipment of marble from Metana for the prophet's beard. So stop flapping your yaps and get to work.
Oh, okay.
Allow me to walk you away, Master.
I wonder what weird, suspicious things are going on with that statue.
Yeah.
Truth be told, I lied. But I cannot have them panic again. The workers he mentioned, they've indeed vanished.
Well, I found two of them, so it's fine.
Yeah. Stop staring directly into the camera, Geralt.
He's commiserating. It's fine.
Alright.
Alright. We got... That'll do it, I think.
Well, it's hard on the nerves, eh? Let's do that. Let's go.
We got all the workers to start working again.
Yeah.
A bit less bombastic than I had hoped from the quest description, but it was alright.
You know, that's not as bad as a cow quest could have. I expected stupid wizard.
I was hoping stupid wizard, but...
We'll get a stupid wizard, I guarantee it.
We have to get a stupid wizard. That's like a serious staple by now.
I know, right?
Alright, that'll do it. Thanks for watching. Next time we're actually going to go ahead and further the plot. Weird.
Pfft, I'll believe it when I see it.
Well, I suppose I can loot some boxes instead for an hour.
There we go.
Alright, see ya.
Goodbye.
I'm sorry.